Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I feel like it's been so long since I did a video. Today I'm going to be making a video on girl talk. So actually, that girl talk is one of my favorite videos to do, especially when it comes to talking situations about dating. And that's exactly what this video is going to be geared towards today, dating. I am always talking about, you know, telling ladies how they need to know their worth and, you know, don't take less from guys and, you know, always, you know, be sure you're not letting anyone waste your time that's not waste right for you, basically. So today I'm going to talk from a different angle, an angle I never talked about before. I'm going to talk about how sometimes that even when we get Mr. Right, sometimes us not changing things that have maybe harmed things in our previous relationships, it can cause Mr. Right to not feel like he's the one when reality is you. So basically I'm talking about how you need to fix yourself to make sure, you know, that you are right for Mr. Right, that you are, you know, deserving of Mr. Right, if you will. So yes, I can speak from my point because I know that me, I am definitely a spoiled young lady. I had told you that several times, and I can be a bit stubborn too, and spoiled and stubborn together can be a bit much. So for those of you who don't know, I was married for 3 years. I married at the age of 25, and I was married until 28, and that's when I divorced. And he was a wonderful guy. He wasn't the guy for me. But some of the things that I did were just, some of the things that I did when I was married in a relationship was just downright selfish. And I didn't accept that until maybe, when the marriage, after the divorce was over, I began to look back and just, you know, go over not just my marriage, but also previous relationships that I had, to see, you know, what could you have done better? Because if you're not fixing things that could have been that caused problems in your previous relationships, then you know, you could harm Mr. Right when you find him. You know, Mr. Right doesn't deserve that. Neither does Mrs. Right. You deserve to give each other the best, to be compromising, you know, things of that nature. So basically, yeah, we had one problem in my previous marriage, and it was just something that it basically for me. Let's talk about my flaws first. I don't like showing my emotions. I'm very bad with that. And I don't like saying if I'm hurt or something. So basically, if someone did something to hurt me, I'll nag and try to irritate that person and get on their nerves. But never will I say, oh, you hurt my feelings. Why'd you do that? That's something that I do, and that's bad. So basically, when my marriage, I felt like it was ending, I would agitate him so badly because pretty much I was scared, I was disappointed that I knew that the marriage was ending. But the bottom line is, I could have changed it had I not been so harsh and cruel. It'd be like, the man would, anything that I could ask for, he would try to do because he understood that I was unhappy. And he could, like, if he would have brought the sun, and I'd have been like, so you couldn't get the moon too? You know, and that's wrong, you know? So that was things, flaws of mine, you know? And another thing is, I do know in some previous relationships, people have like kind of hinted at the fact that, you know, oh, you know, you act like a guy sometimes, they would say, you just like a guy of the relationship. And in my younger years, I didn't understand, but then I realized, yeah, because, you know, guys usually are like holding in their emotions, but I'm a girl, and, you know, a lot of women, they just put their emotions out there, but I don't. However, I wouldn't. I was just like, you know, I could want to say I love you, and I got to sit there and prep myself. Like, say it, Monique, say it, girl, say it. It's funny because I see a lot of people with big personalities like mine, and they say that, you know, I'm really a shy person, and I can totally relate because really, if I go into a room with strangers or anything, I'm the life of the party, you know, I don't need any drinks to get up, I'm going to enjoy me. You would think the party was for me, even if it's not. But when it comes to showing my emotions, I'm very shy. And yeah, very shy. I don't like opening up. I'm very, you know, I know that's a way of protecting myself, but even when it comes to like family and stuff, you know, my close friend, I'll say I love you, but it took me a while to get there. I'm getting so much better over the years, but it took me a while to get there. And I am 31 years old, 31 years young, for anyone that didn't know my age or whatever. And so, yeah, I want to talk about that. So basically, work on yourself. So right now, I am newly dating. I have met a wonderful man. Let me just tell you guys, I consider myself privileged for having a second chance at love. You know, I actually got him a card recently that said that because when my first marriage was actually a good guy, right? And no one tells you when you're unhappy with a good guy, no one can understand that. And I understand why, because even me, I questioned myself because, you know, it's easy to find someone that'll treat you wrong and everyone's gonna tell you to leave him. But when you're complaining about someone not working for you when the guy is right and doing everything correctly, people are gonna be like, you know, well, maybe you need to do A, B, and C. But, and one thing about chemistry is something you can't fake. And unfortunately, my ex-husband and I never, you know, got that. It could have been because of reasons of me. I totally understand that. But the fact of the matter is there was no chemistry there and I was unhappy, you know. So I needed to go. And we're really good friends, so there's no bitter subject for me. But as I said, I am dating a wonderful man right now. And what I found myself doing is some of the same things to him. Even though there was chemistry, I was happy. But as soon as one thing happened, I went into that mode where I started being mean, just agitating, like just, you know, oh, well, I didn't really need this and you didn't have to do this for me. Just being ungrateful and rude. And I felt myself doing it. One day I could see the hurt in his face and I said, you know, I'm sorry. I said, you know what, I'm going through a lot with my family right now and it's not even concerning you and I'm taking that out on you. And, you know, because I felt like, you know, I didn't have time to try to, you know, work on a relationship right now. I just need my space. I said, just give me my space. And let me tell you, he was not trying to hear the space thing. He was like, you know, I can work around it. It's okay. And I was like, you know what? You don't deserve that. You know, you're a really good guy. And my attitude right now is totally inappropriate. And I'm at an age now where I understand that you don't deserve what I'm giving you. So let me just back up. And no, you know, he did. He stayed right there. When I tried to pull away, he wouldn't let me pull away. He stayed right there and supported me through what I was going through, my situation in my life right now. He stayed right there and supported me, encouraged me, and prayed for me and played with me. And that is a beautiful thing. You know, when you have someone that's on the same page as you, that is one thing also. I know, yes, two religions can get along together. My ex-husband was also, we didn't have the same faith. He was actually Muslim and I'm Christian. You know, nothing against that, but I just felt like, you know, I couldn't relate as tightly as I wanted to. For some Christians, I know that's fine, but for me, no, I just wanted us to be praying the same exact way and everything. That was just, you know, I just need God. I know I'm a lot to deal with. Relationships can be hard, and it's always good to have God as your foundation. You know, I don't want my faith to be the faith holding us together. I want our faith to be. So on days when my faith is lacking, your faith can pick me up, if you will. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, it's very important. Let me tell you something too. I was talking about the guy, the wonderful man that I'm dating. Now, he would not leave. Okay, so I agree that if a man or a lady really wants to be with you, they won't leave at the first sight of danger, okay? They're not going to leave. They understand you're not perfect because none of us are. But if someone really doesn't want to be with you, they'll look for anything. You can breathe too hard, okay? You can cough too loud and they'll leave you. That's just something that simple. They'll find a reason. But when someone really wants to be with you, they're going to try their hardest. They're not gonna run at the first sight of danger. They're gonna try their hardest to say, hey, no, let's try it this way. No, honey, I understand, baby, this, that, and the third. So understand that, ladies. You don't have to beg someone to know that you are great, okay? Because a good person, a good woman or man is going to look at you and see that, yeah, that you have a flaw there, but the love in you, the good is definitely outweighing the bad. So you want to go for that person. So never think that you have to convince someone that you're good enough. You don't have to convince any man or woman that you're good enough for them. If they don't feel the same way you and want the same things that you do, that's why I say, my exes, no, I have nothing against them. You know, there's nobody that you can get. I don't care what they look like, what they have, that you can make me feel bad about you having them. There's nothing that you can't, because you didn't think that I was good enough to compromise for us to be what we needed. So toodles to you. I wish you the best. No hard feelings, but no. There's no way you could ever make me jealous, because for one, I'm the queen of my world and she thinks she's all that. She does. And and it's just like, you know, yeah, if someone doesn't want, it doesn't make you a bad person, basically. You date a lot of people that if the timing is not right, etc., it doesn't make you a bad person. But what I think you should always do is go back into your previous relationships like I did. Find out what you did wrong. If it's something that's a constant coming denominator, look at that and figure out should you change it. Because a good person, a person that's doing everything right, and they're saying, if you point out something that you don't like and they're willing to change it, you need to start telling yourself and let the person know about that. Like I told, you know, my boyfriend, hey, you know, this is something that I struggle with. You know, I struggle with showing my emotions. So don't think because I don't say I love you when you say it, or, you know, I'm a little, you know, shy in this area, that, you know, I'm working towards that. And sometimes when I'm in a bad mood, you know, I may shut down. You know, I just want to be alone. You know, you have to explain to somebody, because some people will think that you want to be alone and you're just ignoring them. But those are some things. But I work on this mouth of mine, because you know what? this thing here needs to be closed sometimes. And sometimes when you're angry, you don't think before you speak. So basically what we're doing is we watch some couples here on YouTube together, you know, because we're working on our foundation and trying to have solution for problems even before they begin. And it's very important when you're dating someone, do that. Work on your problems before they begin. You know, like we're talking about already, like, you know, we're never gonna go to sleep when we're mad. You know, someone's gonna say, you know, I'm sorry, you know, and he's so good at it that he's encouraging me to. Like, I'm trying to beat him to the punch. Like, you know, I'm sorry, and, you know, let's not go to sleep mad, and let's do this, you know. It's already, we're just coming up with things. You know, when you find a man or woman and you guys both know what you want, it doesn't matter what the time frame. It could be 1 month and you guys will already be talking about future. This is what's going to happen if we do this. And, oh, if we did A, B, C, and this is how this is going to go. And then we're going to go here. And then the vacation, we both want to go to Fiji. And it's just going to be so great. So that's what I'm telling you. You don't have to. It's going to be like, God, for me? I mean, you gave me exactly what I wanted. That's what I'm talking about. So, yeah, God will give you, if you are doing your part. And I believe for me, my part was, I went on several dates this year. And guess what? The majority of them didn't get a second date. It wasn't worth my time, and I was quick to dismiss that because, see, I know what she wanted. She had a vision and she knew what she was wanting, and she's not settling for less. So let me tell you something about settling for less. When you know what you want, you're gonna be spend a lot of time single, because see, some if men can spell, you know, desperation from a mile away, and if they just know you just want some attention and you need someone to tell you that you're beautiful, then they'll do just that, just to have you tagging along. And they know that you're asking them for something, but if they don't give it to you, you're still gonna stay. Then I wouldn't follow what you asked me for either. Same thing with ladies. If you're gonna put up with anything, why would I change anything? You know, you have to know that, hey, no. These are my demands. This is what I'm looking for. Oh, okay, you don't want the same things? That was nice knowing you. You don't have a good life. No hard feelings. Just understand that because of my determination to keep striving for what I look for, God sent it to me. And you know what? What if our relationship doesn't work? That doesn't mean that this wasn't a good catch for me. This is the situation. Just to have someone love you for you unconditionally, make you feel special. You know, everything that you thought was wrong with you, he says, no, it's not that much. You're not asking for too much. You know, the people who don't want the same things you want will always say, you're too spoiled. They don't want the same things. But that, let me tell you, when that knight in shining armor comes, he's going to say, oh, baby, that's not too much. That's not nothing. There's nothing wrong with spoiling a good lady. That's the kind of things he's going to say. And that's what my king says to me. And, you know, so he makes me want to be better. And he said those same things to me. And it's just like, you know, God, thank you. But let me tell you something. Like, a month ago, I was ready to, like, cut him off because I was doing the same thing that had ruined previous relationships for me. So what I'm telling you is that I'm growing. I've grown from that 23-year-old girl when I started dating my ex-husband. I'm 31 years old now. It doesn't matter how long it takes you to change it, but look inside yourself, because you don't have to do a total 360 and become someone that you don't recognize. But there's always something that we can all improve. And if you love someone, you want to give them the best of you. You know, if someone's giving you their best, you want to give them your best. So what I'm telling you is, always constantly evaluate yourself, as I did, and let that person know, I'm trying, you know, I want to be to better you, baby, I'm sorry, you know, always, you know, whatever that person likes, you know, you do that for them to let them know that you're trying. Constantly date each other. We're talking about that already. We're going to constantly date each other. We're going to uplift each other. We're going to encourage you. We're going to pray together all the time. Set the foundation so the devil can understand, hey, we're in this to win it. Okay, we're in it to win it. So there's going to be things, but we're ready for it. We're preparing ourselves in advance. So, you know, it's never going to be peaches and cream already, but it's something about being prepared. No matter what you're doing in life, if you're prepared, it's going to go a whole lot smoother than if you were not prepared. So I just want you ladies to know, you know, we got to talk about different angles of relationships. It's been a while since I did a video, period, let alone girl talk, but I'm going to be keeping this going. I'm definitely going to be giving you a journey of my dating journey with my boyfriend that I'm currently with. And, you know, I'm looking forward to great beginnings with him and sharing my life with you guys. And he's supporting, like, he's watching some of my little videos and, you know, giving me his input. He's an IT man, so he probably helped me get a little bit more fancy with the video. No rush for that, though, but I told him, I said, you know, once we do, you know, because I was watching some of the other couples, as I said, and we were sharing some of their, you know, things that they talked about in their relationships and, you know, just how we can be better for each other and things like that. And, yeah, I promise you, we're going to be sharing our journey of love with you guys. So thank you so much. I just wanted to share that with you guys. You have a wonderful day. Mwah, 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 mwah.